إن نويت الأربعين نويت الاعتكاف نويت الخلوة نويت العزلة نويت الرياضة نويت الرياضة نويت السلوك لله تعالى العظيم في هذا المسجد. أطيعوا الله وأطيعوا الرسول وأولي الأمر منكم. Obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, obey your leaders and obey those who are on authority. Alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has granted us life to see this aid also. InshaAllah, Allah always give us good health, good life to see more and more each Eid al-Adha. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said kun fayakun, be and it will be. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala between two letters, when he said, when his irada came, when his will came for this creation to appear from the reality, the light, for the sake of Sayyidina Muhammad alayhi afdal as-salatu wa as-salam, for his beloved prophet, beloved servant, that Allah described him in his reality as Muhammad Rasulullah. The reality that always is dependent, servanthood is dependent on lordship, is that reality which describes the servanthood is Muhammad Rasulullah. And that's why it is dependent on Allah. For that reason, it has to follow always the Creator. And that's why came La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. And Muhammad Rasulullah always is following, showing complete submission to La ilaha illallah. And the only way to لا إله إلا الله through محمد رسول الله. There is no other way to لا إله إلا الله except محمد رسول الله. Prophet came, he showed the way. So محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم showed the way to لا إله إلا الله. Allah said in Holy Quran, وقت البيوت من أبوابها. He didn't say other than that. He said come come to my presence or come to the house from its door, from the door. So the door to the Creator, not as they say, there is no door, there is a door, or that there is no Muhammad Rasulullah. If there is no door, why to say Muhammad Rasulullah? Why to say لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله؟ Say only Allah, لا إله إلا الله, finish. But your Islam is not Islam then, because Christian and others, they say لا إله إلا الله. They say there is a Creator. But what differentiates us, distinct us, how we become believers? By saying محمد رسول الله. So eliminating Muhammad Rasulullah as the door, what to be used in abwabiha, how is through the way of Sayyidina Muhammad alayhi wa sallam, he is the door of that house. Means he is the door of reaching to declare the oneness and the lordship of your Lord. So there is no other way except to say Muhammadun Rasulullah, as it is mentioned in the hadith of the blind man, that it is being the famous hadith, that when the blind man came to ask Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that he can be able to see, and Prophet told him the hadith, اللهم اني اسالك واتوجه اليك بنبيك محمد نبي الرحمه. Oh Allah, I am asking you and coming to you through your prophet, the prophet of mercy. يا محمد, oh Muhammad. إني أتوجه بك إلى ربي. I am going to my Lord through you. He is the door. That's why Muhammad Rasulullah follow لا إله إلا الله. Without that, you are not Muslim. Without saying, you drop Muhammad Rasulullah. So the reality there of Muhammad Rasulullah, that reality, that description, Muhammad, the messenger of Allah, is a name and a description. Muhammad is a name. A name of an essence, a substance. And Rasulullah is the description of that essence. Muhammad is its name. The description is Rasulullah. So the attribute of that essence, or the as-sifat wal-asma, essence is Muhammad. Attribute, sifat, what's the sifat? Adjective? Or the description is Rasulullah. Rasulullah is the messenger of Allah. He's describing that essence which is the name as Muhammad. That essence, that name as Muhammad, is carrying lot of description. One of them is Rasulullah. From that essence, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is dressing this with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's vision, Allah sending his tajalli, bestowing his tajalli, his endless blessings on Sayyidina Muhammad alayhi afdal, on that essence. When Allah is sending like Asma al-Nabi, how many names Prophet has? 200 names. There are more. There are more than 200. That's 200 that we know. There are 500 also. And there are infinite number of names, because the essence of Muhammad Rasulullah describes the whole creation. It is the premise. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the قبضت قبضة من نوري قلت لها قولي محمد. I took a hand of my light and I said be محمد. And from that light I create creation. He created محمد first, and from the light created creation. From that reality, from that essence coming out. Like, what is the color of this? What is the color of this? What do you say? Oh, white. It's white or black? That's black. No, it's white. How you prove it's black? It's white. I'm saying it's white. You're saying it's black. الله أكبر. It's right. So it's right or blessed?
Right.
Because you don't have the eyes to see. We don't have the eyes to see. This is not all right. In your eyes. But someone else might see it like a light. It depends how you can see. This is scary a light also. But you cannot see the light. Why are you not seeing the light? Because it's not reflected. Only the black is being reflected out, you are seeing it. But in reality, light also going in, all colors are in, are passing through. Is that? These photons are going through, so they can penetrate through that substance, through that that solid. The only thing you see is that, but in reality that's what you are seeing, but in reality it has all colors in it. They are going through. So what is the color of that? It has white, it has red, it has blue, it has yellow, it has all kinds of colors, it has a rainbow of colors. Ranging from white to black. And what you are seeing is black. And what you can see might be white then. So if you cannot say there is no white, someone who has a better vision than you can see it might be red. There are these can see infrared. Can you see this? They can see. Huh? So you cannot say it doesn't exist. So the light is existing in this machine, but you are not seeing it. So when someone had this eye vision, power of that vision, basira, what's basira in English? The knowledge of vision can see that this is not only black, it's all kinds of colors coming in. So how you are going to understand the reality of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Islam? And he said, oh, look, he came and the finish. That's why Allah can understand more. As we are going deeper and deeper in that reality, they can pull out more. Like Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from his attempt to his reality. If Allah is blessing him, blessing him, blessing him. Dressing him. Allah is dressing what? Allah is dressing what? When you have this cloth on you, this is your cloth, it's not you. I cannot say this is Tahir or this is Adnan. These are clothes. Your reality, your body is under the cloth. When I want to mention, to understand you, I say, I describe your clothes and your personality. Good, generous, active, patient, but it is not you. So the essence is different. The reality of that essence that being dressed so it appears with different description is different. Understood? So means this different light, this different tajalli that Allah is dressing the essence of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That essence is separate from the reality. So as Allah is dressing it with these infinite attributes, so what comes out we are seeing, people are seeing and understanding from Prophet is this reality. Is the description of that essence. Not the essence, said no one knows the essence except Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his Lord. As you look at If you have a sunny day and through the window coming these rays, what you see on these rays? You can see them, isn't it? Very small dust floating around. As Allah bestowed His infinite mercy on prophets, different attributes, with these attributes that we breath, every attribute is carrying floating particles. As through the as you can see through the rays of the sun coming through into the sea, these particles everywhere floating. These are appearances that you cannot see it without the sun, right? The ray of the sun. Because it is the source of light. So as this sun is the source of light, so the light, the rays comes out. It is the energy and it produces light, beams of light. These beams, as it comes from the source of energy, the sun, it shows you things that you cannot see before. You cannot say, now I'm looking here, you cannot say there is no particle floating in the air. It is there. You cannot see it. Like it's the light of this. You said black. No, it's white. It's a range of different colors, but you cannot see it because it's going through. But someone has vision, can see it. So these particles floating at this ray sun, you see that. As these bestowed Rahma mercy on the reality, on the essence of prophet, this reality appears. Every light by itself with all its floating particles. And every floating particle is a complete universe by itself. Coming out of the reality of the essence of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to a reality. This everyone is a universe, galaxies, billions of stars coming out every second from this. Allah is sending on His beloved one, on His, the essence of the beloved one. The essence is the description, is the symbol of submission. And that's why it's Muhammad Rasulullah, follow me. La ilaha illallah, always. It's always in frustration. Well, that essence is frustrating. He's everything on that essence. Coming out of it is in frustration. He's all universes, he's all its creation inside it, including us, are always in frustration, in the frustration of prophets. Never raising their heads up. Always obedient to their laws. That's why, إِنَّ لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّ إِلَيْهِ رَجْعُونَ. Allah gave his soul back. And that soul always in frustration. Never spirit is outside frustration. Always in sajda, because it is part of that whole, and the whole is Muhammad Rasulullah. Part of the whole is always in the whole. Part of it. Like a drop of water, take it out of the cup, you see the drop on your hand. Put it back, it disappears. So the part disappears in the whole. So always that part is in frustration. As the whole is in frustration, the part is in frustration. Understood? So these realities that are every moment being dressed on the essence of Muhammad Rasulullah, these realities, as they appear, become appearances in this universe. And every moment, Allah is the creator. As Allah is the creator, He is the creator infinite. Creator means creation is infinite. Cannot stop. As creation is infinite, these appearances coming infinite. So all that is coming from Allah is bestowing it on His beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. These realities appear, and all of them محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ازاي ادي المسنجر اوف الله كده. And what Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم the utters is taking from the creator from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the utters is taking absorbing that knowledge. When it's absorbing that knowledge, when it comes through the essence, it comes out as appearances, this tajalli that Allah sent in, the reality begin to take that knowledge out, whatever is from the essence of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, revealing to reality is understanding. Reality is understanding. It gives these universes. And this is a deep ocean. Inshallah, I explain that in detail in these lectures. And may Allah forgive us. And may Allah give us the benefits of tonight, the night of Eid, Eid al-Adha. And inshallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestow on us the love of his beloved Prophet Sayyidina Muhammad alayhi wa sallam, Harmat al-Habib, Harmat al-Fatiha.